Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. Microsoft released their 2024 update for Windows 11, better known as 24H2, just a few days ago. And as you probably know if you're watching this video, Windows 11 comes with some specific hardware requirements. In this video, I'll show you how you can upgrade your current installation of Windows 11 on unsupported hardware to the newest version of that same operating system, 24H2. If you are already running Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, you know that theoretically it requires your machine to support secure boot, have a TPM 2.0 module, and your CPU to be on the list of compatible models. By working around these hardware checks, it has been possible to run Windows 11 without any issues. Performance is pretty good and similar to Windows 10, updates are working fine, and all in all, everything works just as you would expect. What does require some action is that with each major update, as was the case last year for 23H2, the year before for 22H2, and now as well with the latest version, 24H2, the methods that you can use to skip these hardware checks during installation or while upgrading do change a bit. For each of these in the past, I've been documenting a new workaround, and this video is no difference to that. As there are multiple possible scenarios to get Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported machine, depending on your starting point, I decided to publish 3 separate videos covering each of these. This video is applicable when you are already on an earlier version of Windows 11, like 23H2, 22H2, or even older, on unsupported hardware. If you're looking to upgrade an existing Windows 10 installation directly to the latest 24H2 version of Windows 11 instead, you can use the video for which I'll put a card here now. And if you're looking how to do a fresh installation of Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported hardware, you can use the one that appears here now. So, for this video, I'll be using my Dell Optiplex 9020, which I also used in the past to test and play around with Windows 11. Currently, I have version 23H2 on here, which I managed to install using one of the known workaround methods. As you can see, it is equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, which is not supported, and the edition of Windows 11 that is currently on here is the Home Edition. As you can also see here, this installation has been activated with Microsoft, and I intend to keep it that way. And just to be clear, this method will work equally fine if you are on Windows 11 Professional or on an earlier Windows 11 version, in case you would doubt about that. If we go to Windows Update, we can see that I already have all available updates installed. Searching for more keeps telling me the same thing. Yet, we still remain on version 23H2. So, as I already mentioned, and as was the case for previous major updates as well on unsupported hardware, we will need to push this system to 24H2 ourselves. One thing that I need to mention here that is really different from 23H2 is that since version 24H2, Microsoft started to rely on a specific SSE 4.2 CPU instruction called POPCNT. In other words, this is a real hardware limitation. So, CPUs that do not have this instruction built in will not be able to run 24H2, and the bad news is that if you would have such a CPU, your system will no longer boot anymore after upgrading. The good news is that your CPU needs to be over 15 years old for this to be the case. For Intel CPUs, for example, anything that is an Intel Core CPU or newer, which was introduced back in 2008 already, or for AMD, about everything that got released after the same year, does have support for that instruction. So unless you have a really, really old CPU, you should be fine. So let's get started now and force that upgrade to 24H2 on this 23H2 Windows 11 system. To start, we need to get the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft. So let's open our browser and navigate to the page where we can download Windows 11. As you can see, there are several options available here. You could download the ISO directly over here, but I recommend to do this instead by using the media creation tool. The reason for that is that this tool will automatically detect the language of your original installation and download the same version. If there would be a mismatch, even if the display language is seemingly fine, you could end up in the situation where you can't upgrade and keep your files. Once the tool is downloaded, let's start it from our downloads folder. And accept the license terms. Here we can see that the language is now automatically detected, which we wanted, so let us leave the use recommended options for this PC as it is. Then we need to choose to download just the ISO. Click Next and choose where the tool should put the file. I will put it in my Downloads folder and call it Windows 11 24H2. After this, the media creation tool will download the required files and the ISO will be created where you told it to. There we are. We should be able to find the ISO now in our Downloads folder, so let's open that. Now that we have it here, we need to mount the ISO. You can do that by simply right-clicking on the file and then choose Mount. This creates a new drive letter, which in my case is the letter D, as you can see here as well. This is like a virtual DVD drive which has the necessary installation files in it. Now to work around those hardware checks, we need to launch the setup program with a special argument. This is a method that was working for earlier versions as well, and we need to use it as the alternative option, which we use for 23H2 to push a specific update package, no longer works. In order to continue with the upgrade now, we need to start a command prompt. So press start, type cmd, and press enter. In here, we need to switch to that mounted ISO's drive letter. In my case, that was the letter D, if you remember, so I need to type D colon and press enter. Obviously, you need to adapt this to a different letter if that was the case for you. By using the dir command, we can verify now that we have the correct drive letter, as we can see exactly the same files here as on that mounted ISO. Next, we will need to start setup.exe and add that argument that I mentioned. So let's type setup slash product server and press enter. This will launch the in-place upgrade. As you can see, it mentions here that this will install Windows Server. Don't worry about that at all, as it will just upgrade the currently installed Windows Edition, which in my case is Home, but this will bypass the hardware checks. Here, make sure to click Change House Setup Download Updates, and then select Not Right Now. Click Next. Accept the license terms, and choose Keep File Settings and Apps to just perform an upgrade of your currently installed Windows 11 version to the new Windows 11 24H2. Finally, in here, we already get a confirmation that we'll just upgrade to Windows 11 Home, in case you would still be worried about that. Now let's click on Install to begin the process. At this point, the version of the OS is getting upgraded to 24H2, and you'll need to be a bit patient. If all goes well, you should eventually end back at your desktop, but this time you should be on Windows 11 24H2. For me, this process took about 15 to 20 minutes, which I think is still pretty fast seeing how old the hardware I have is. That's it. Our Windows 11 23H2 installation should now have been upgraded, so let us verify that. In System About, we can see that I'm still on that same unsupported hardware, but now we have Windows 11 Home 24H2 on here. In terms of activation, my machine is still activated, so that whole slash product server thing did not mess up anything. And to double check, let's see if we can find some of the changes that were introduced in this new version. The quick settings, for example, now has pages. In File Explorer, if we try to compress a file, we can now also choose multiple formats. And it looks like we have the new phone link application available and working as well. Those are just a few small examples of the changes, but more importantly, as you could see, we upgraded to the latest and greatest version of Windows 11 on this unsupported hardware. That was all for the video. I hope this will help you to extend the life of your machine. If you have liked this video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Let me know how this worked for you or if you have any questions in the comments. And make sure to subscribe if you like these kind of videos. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.